1960s, a young French writer, Jules Verne, wrote a novel with title of From the Earth to the Moon, which was published in 1865. This novel was part of his series of novels called Extraordinary Voyages. In his novel, Verne imagines a group of adventurers building a cannon so large that it can shoot a bullet-shaped capsule with three occupants to the moon. The main characters succeed not in landing on the moon, but in orbiting it. Their stories continue in the novel's sequel, Around the Moon, which was published in 1870. That deals with what happens to the three men in their travel from the Earth to the Moon. The story of Jules Verne opens sometime after the end of the American Civil War. The Baltimore Gun Club, a society dedicated to the design of weapons of all kinds, especially cannons, comes together when Impey Barbie Kane, its president, calls them to support his latest idea. He's done some calculations and believes that they could construct a cannon capable of shooting a projectile to the moon. After receiving the support of his companions, another meeting is held to decide the place from which the projectile will be fired. The dimensions and materials of both the cannon and the projectile and which kind of powder they are to use. Stones Hill in Tampa Town, Florida is chosen as the site for the cannon's construction. The gun club travels there and starts the construction of the Columbiad Cannon, which requires the excavation of a 900 foot deep and 60 foot wide circular hole, which is made in the nick of time. Meanwhile, Barbicane finds the solution to the problem of surviving the incredible acceleration that the explosion would cause. Erdan suggests that Barbicane and Nicole travel with him in the projectile, and the proposition is accepted. In the end, the projectile is successfully launched. Having been fired out of the giant Columbiad space gun, the Baltimore Gun Club's bullet-shaped projectile, along with its three passengers, Barbicane, Nicole, and Mikhail Erdan, begins the five-day trip to the moon. A few minutes into the journey, a small bright asteroid passes within a few hundred yards of them, but does not collide with the projectile. The three travelers undergo a series of adventures and misadventures during the rest of the journey, including disposing of the body of a dog out a window, suffering intoxication by gases, and making calculations leading them briefly to believe that they are to fall back to Earth. During the later part of the voyage, it becomes apparent that the gravitational force of their earlier encounter with the asteroid has caused the projectile to deviate from its course. The projectile enters lunar orbit rather than landing on the moon as originally planned. Barbicane, Erdan, and Nicole begin geographical observations with opera glasses. The projectile then dips over the northern hemisphere of the moon into the darkness of its shadow. It is plunged into extreme cold before emerging into the light and heat again. They then begin to approach the moon's southern hemisphere. From the safety of their projectile, they gain spectacular views of Tycho, one of the greatest of all craters on the moon. The three men discuss the possibility of life on the moon and conclude that it is barren. The projectile begins to move away from the moon. Erdan hits upon the idea of using the rockets fixed to the bottom of the projectile, which they were originally going to use to deaden the shock of landing, to propel the projectile towards the moon and hopefully cause it to fall onto it, thereby achieving their mission. When the projectile reaches the point of neutral attraction, the rockets are fired, but it is too late. The projectile begins a fall onto the Earth with the same speed at which it left the mouth of the Columbiad. All hope seems lost for Barbicane, Nicole, and Erdan. 4 days later, the crew of a US Navy vessel spots a bright meteor fall from the sky into the sea. This turns out to be the returning projectile. A rescue operation is assembled. After several searches, the projectile and the three men inside are found to be alive and well. They are treated to lavish homecoming celebrations as the first people to leave Earth.